Warriors, Field Guides, Secrets of the Clans. Oh, that's a long book title. It's longer than it needs to be, really. It's a fairly basic spin-off book for the Warriors series. It's an encyclopedia which lists most of the places and things from the Warriors books. It doesn't have a comprehensive list of characters and events, which is what I was hoping for. The book is supplemented by many short stories, 1 to 4 pages mostly. We start with a story of how the Cat Clans came into existence. It was ghosts. The forest was full of fighting cats until ghosts showed up and asked them to split up into 4 clans. The clans were named after their 4 leaders, and they got 9 lives for creating the Warrior Code. The Warrior Code is written down in full. I like that. I wish the actual books gave a comprehensive listing of the Warrior Code, instead of leaving it for a side book like this. The rules of the Warrior Code are not explained. Why aren't new warriors allowed to talk for a night? I find it weird that the first rule is that you can have friends in other clans while being loyal to your own clan. There is so much drama in these books over having friends in other clans. It's literally the first rule of Warrior Code. Why is it a problem? Next is a description of the camp territories. You get a picture of the territory from the first series, with a description of each location. Next is a tour of the camp, narrated by one of the cats. Then you get the exact same thing for the territory from the second series. Then a bulleted list of the most important cats from that clan. I found this section to be boring and repetitive. And surprise, it's the longest section of the book. Each clan gets 1 short story. Thunder Clan talks about the dog attack. Wind Clan talks about when they were forced out of the forest. Shadow Clan talks about the birth of Yellow Fang's child. That was pretty good. River Clan talks about when Silverstream's kits almost drowned. I guess the author likes River Clan best because they get a second story where Leopard Star complains she should not be judged for siding with Tiger Star in the Great War. This only convinces me she deserved a much harsher punishment for her role in Tiger Star conquering the forest. The book attempts to have a tour for Star Clan, but it instantly runs into the problem that we don't know much about Star Clan or what it looks like, so that section does not last very long. You know how they have maps in the front of every single book? Every map gets reprinted here like it is new exclusive material. This is followed by a list of various locations, like Four Trees or the Moon Pool, each with a short story. Rock talks about the Lake Territory. I was greatly confused by Rock in Power of Three Dark River, because he appears without any introduction. I guess the author figured, there is no need to introduce Rock. All the readers will remember his 1-page appearance in this book. Next is a section that explains all the possible warrior jobs, like apprentice, deputy, so on. There's a story about Cloudtail's time with humans, and Crowfeather describing his forbidden romance. That doesn't really belong after a description of what clan elders are, but I guess they couldn't think of a better place for those stories. There's a list of prophecies and a list of cats that don't live in clans. This comes with a story about Scourge, who is incorrectly called Blood. Scourge is super violent and using Barley's brothers to attack Barley's sister. The book wraps up with 3 clan myths, like how snakes came to Thunder Clan territory, how River Clan got the River territory, and how tigers got their stripes. I'd still like to know how the clan cats know what lions, tigers, and leopards are. That's it for the book. It's fine. I like the short stories best of all because they're new material. The rest is a lot like reading an encyclopedia about the Warrior Cat series. It definitely felt like they were stretching things out to make the book longer at certain points. Like, the final part of the book is a glossary of cat terms. It's 3 pages long. Really? The illustrations are nice, and there's definitely enough new content to entertain fans of the series. I'd prefer it if the vast majority of the book was new material, though, not just a basic rehash of how clan life works. I'd recommend getting it from a library over buying it if you can. I give Warrior's Field Guide Secret of the Clans a thumbs up.